We're going to be discussing pistols today, specifically this Walther PDP Compact with a 5-inch slide. And as someone who has put thousands of rounds through the PPQ, this is going to be a collection of my observations of what I feel Walther got right with the new PDP and maybe some things that I'm not too blown away by. This PPQ M2 Navy SD with a threaded barrel, you can't see right now, was the first centerfire pistol I purchased of all time. It didn't start life like this, obviously. It has a red dot sight. In this case, it was cut for a Vortex Viper 6 MOA dot. Trigicon HD night sights that do just barely co-witness. It has a Jarvis compensator. And courtesy of Terran Tactical, it has a 20-round magazine with this +5 base plate. When it got set away to be cut for the red dot, I went ahead and got this 5-inch to run designated with iron sights and to shoot in USPSA, which I ended up doing for 2 seasons. As much as I like them, I am well aware of the fact that I am in the minority. As a gun guy, you really have to feel for Walther. You ask most people what comes to mind when they hear the words Walther, and they're going to say it's either the preferred pistol of a certain soon-to-be-canceled secret agent.
No more foreplay.
Or the firearm responsible for the most celebrated suicide of all time. When the PPQ first arrived in the US, it didn't have this button-style mag release that we're all used to. It had the ambi trigger housing blade-style mag release, a la HK, and that went about as well as
a good evening.
Go back to your own country.
So the first major change was to the magazine release via the button. Of course, these were not initially available with a optics cut. But gradually, the Q5 match came out, then the Q4 tack, then the steel frames. And all of those were clear steps in the direction of tactical-minded shooters. You have much more aggressive grip texture. You have much more aggressive slide serrations. You have a slide that is wide enough to be cut for an optic out of the box, and it is, in fact, cut for an optic out of the box. As opposed to the PPQ variants that were optics cut, this plate does not replace the rear slide, so you can have a co-witness sight. These sights are no longer proprietary in shape. They are standard Glock sights, so anything you could run on a Glock, you could run on this. You may be watching this not as a Walther guy, but as a Glock guy, and you may be thinking to yourself, hey, tactical accountants, why would I want this Walther when my Glock says perfection right on the box? So I am going to try to work this in whenever possible and relevant. Starting with the PPQ. £5, just shy of 12 ounces. £5, 6 ounces. PDP. £4, 7 ounces. £4, 13 ounces. For my Glock guys, Glock 19 Gen 4. £7, 2 ounces. £7, 7 ounces. So the PDP trigger is around a pound lighter than the PPQ trigger. I'm going to argue, however, that for serious or duty use, the PDP trigger is safer. With the PPQ, if we take up that first stage, 4 pounds, 6 ounces. And remember, this trigger is breaking at around 5.5 to 6 pounds, just an extra pound to break the shot. And the break on the PPQ is super crisp. If you've ever heard that Geissele analogy for the SSA and SSAE. I mean, the PPQ kind of feels more like a glass rod than a carrot, if you want to talk about it in bendy bill terms. With the PDP, your take up there, that's 3 pounds even. And if we're talking about a trigger break weight of 4.5 to 5 pounds, that is a bigger margin of error. It may not sound like it, that adds up. Furthermore, it's still super crisp, but I would say it kind of does feel more like a carrot snapping than an icicle or a glass rod shattering. There is just that tiny bit of give, of bend, after you squeeze in the wall for the shot to break. Over the thousands of rounds that I've put through my PPQs, I have had a few unanticipated discharges. I wouldn't call them negligent in any way. Pistol was always pointed in a safe direction. With that said, with the PPQ, with that heavy take up, try to be quick. It's not always that predictable. In contrast, the PDP, I was legitimately just trying to take up the slack equally quick between the two of them. And because of the heavier effort required with the PPQ, I broke some of those shots. I didn't break any of the shots with the PDP. That to me is a big deal. Grip texture. When I realized how improved it was going between the back strap sizes. I have pretty decently sized man hands.
Twist off.
I ended up running the large backstrap. I figured it gives me a more consistent, higher grip, and more real estate. So when I got my PDP, the first thing I did was put the large backstrap on as well. And then I started doing a lot of dry firing and trying to get a consistent hand placement. And I realized that because of this more abrasive, in a good way, and grippy texture, the large backstrap actually felt kind of unwieldy for me. And it meant that if I gripped the gun slightly wrong to begin with, it would be difficult to kind of slide up and get it exactly where I wanted it because the grip was so big and abrasive. So I've settled on the medium here. Also, this front checkering a la custom high-end 1911 is pretty cool. Everybody likes 1911s, right? In contrast, Glock and a Glock, I mean, it is what it is. It feels like a 2x4. It's got some grippiness there, but anybody who's cool stipples this themselves. So if you're coming at the PDP as a Glock guy saying, hey, what's the big deal? It's just an upgraded PPQ. Meanwhile, you have a Glock that was supposed to be perfect out of the box and have thrown $1,000 into changing literally everything on it to get it where you want it. Maybe you need to evaluate some things in your life. All right, that should have rustled some jimmies. So moving on to weight. PPQ, 5-inch, 1 pound, 8 ounces. PDP, compact, 5-inch, 1 pound, 6.9 ounces.
Nice.
Glock for scale. 1 pound, 5.4 ounces. Obviously, this is not apples to apples. The Glock 19 is a 4-inch barrel and slide compared to the 5-inch barrel and slide on these long boys. Ounce and a half for an extra inch. Doesn't sound like a bad trade-off. I know I would take it. So if we take the PPQ frame, 6.3 ounces. PDP frame, 6.4 ounces, virtually identical. The PDP slide, or frame, I'm sorry, as you can tell there, is longer. The frame goes the entire length of the slide. What this means is the entire ounce of weight savings is in the slide. one complaint that people often have about the PPQ relative to other 9mm pistols is that it feels snappy. It does have a relatively high bore axis. Since it is the slide, the mass of the slide, that is what is actually moving under recoil, losing an ounce of slide weight relative to the frame, you would think, all other things being equal, which they seem to be, would mean that the PDP would have a slightly softer recoil impulse. PDP slide is chunkier, yet lighter. With the PPQ, you did see that they made an effort at lightening it with these speed holes.
Hey, what are all these holes?
These are speed holes to make the car go faster.
But in contrast to the PDP, the PPQ has metal underneath here at the front of the slide. You can see that hole drilled into it. That's so you can get a Glock front sight tool through there to swap the front sight. So this is one piece of metal. The PDP, you have a plastic bushing that slides in here. If you want to replace the sights on the PDP, which I will be doing, you have to use a tool to kind of get into these slots on this bushing, and then it will just slide out. An interesting choice, this by Walther. Maybe there is a good engineering reason for it. To me, it seems like something that could fail relative to a one-piece metal design. You may also have seen that PPQ slides will work on PDP frames and vice versa. When I take the PDP 5-inch frame and put on the slide from my customized PPQ with the Jarvis compensator, it works. The magazines between the PDP Compact and PPQ are identical. They just don't say PPQ anymore. Both 15 rounders. There is, of course, a longer framed version of the PDP on the market now, the full size, and that comes with 18 round magazines. The 18 rounders will work in this, so that's pretty cool. You can get a factory longer mag for your PDP. It's kind of like running a factory Glock 17 mag in your Glock 19. Less impressive when it comes to touted PDP features is the so-called stepped chamber. If we take a look through the bore there, you can see a step clearly. Walther is really running with this in the advertising materials.
And I'm going to talk to you about the step chamber that Walther uses in the PDP.
My understanding of the step chamber is that it ensures more consistent engagement of the bullet into the rifling and potentially a better seal, making for improved accuracy potential and possibly velocity as well over a regular non-step chamber. So, buying into this, I took both of these long boys out to the range with three different types of 9mm, and I ran them both through the chrono with 5 shots each. I'm not going to bore you with that footage, but check out the numbers on the screen. You may be thinking, hey, those are pretty similar, and you would be right. The reason for that, if we take the PPQ barrel, it turns out the PPQ had a stepped chamber all along. The PDP has adjustable sights. The rear sight via these two screws, one for windage, one for elevation, can be adjusted. Unfortunately, I only discovered after driving to the range with my set of bits from Harbor Freight.
You want to buy from China? That's great. Buy from China.
This is the smallest bit I have in that set, and it is way too broad to engage these screws. Make sure you have a very, very fine flathead to adjust these, something along the lines of an eyeglass repair kit screwdriver. More to the point, because the sight is adjustable and all of the adjustment takes place within the space of this dovetail, and it's not like a suppressor height sight. Compared to the Trigicon HDs I have on one of my PPQs, it's not that easy to pick up the front sight between that notch just because of how shallow it is. So There are definitely some aftermarket sights in the works for this thing. I'm going to be putting a light on it, specifically the Streamlight TLR-1HL. Very bright, very known quantity. For anyone planning to do the same, the best key in terms of fitment is this P320 key. Sits pretty much perfectly flush. You can see there. So easy to reach that switch. Goes without saying that due to the thicker slide, this PPQ holster I had made by, I think it's MI Holster Co. will not work. Not gonna jam it in there. Hopefully the aftermarket catches up. So that's it. That is my honest take on the new Walther PDP. I hope it was of some use to you. If you're still here, thank you very much for watching. We will see you next time.